Hey all, and welcome to another one. So today we don't actually have any real footage to show you guys, I'm afraid. That's because we don't have one of these NVRs on hand and we don't have, you know, 32 cameras to plug into it. But let me explain to you the problem, and hopefully you guys, if you found this video, then it's an easy solution. Okay, so on this NVR, it is twin HDMI output, all right? So when you plug in the second HDMI, what happens a lot is all your pictures are going to just disappear and you're going to get a no resource issue on all the cameras, all right? And there is a reason why it's doing this, and unfortunately you can't change it, but there is a workaround. All right, so what happens is as soon as you activate the second HDMI monitor, you get the no resource issue on every camera. That's because the NVR is maxed out on its amount it can handle. Why is it doing this? Because on the second HDMI, it forces it on mainstream. So when you go to mainstream, it kills the bandwidth, everything. It just can't handle it. And there's no way of unforcing it or when you go to the second display. Oh, but this is only if you go for four cameras. So the trick is, guys, on your second display, you have to change it from four cameras, maybe to nine cameras, 16 cameras, whatever it is. You cannot have it on four. All right, guys, hopefully there'll be a firmware update or something in the future where you can change this. But right now, they kind of force it onto mainstream, which is not a good idea, and it caused us an awful lot of problems with an install. But hopefully now we figured it out what it was going on. Hopefully it saves you a few guys some time and effort, okay? But if you're here because you've got no resource issue and this is not your issue with the second HDMI, let me go through the list of what to do to get rid of it, okay? So first thing to do is make sure on your live view you've selected substream on all the cameras. So you get a little display box at the bottom of the camera, click on substream, okay? And now if you're still getting no resource issue, then follow this in this order, okay? So enable H.264 on the camera. So it goes to the parameters and change it from H.265 to H.264. Okay, then if still not working, then reduce the bitrate on the cameras. Okay, you don't have to do it by much, just a little bit. And if still nothing, then reduce the frame rate. All right, now if you're still having problems with no resource issue, you're doing something wrong, guys. I'm telling you that now. All right, because or if you do all these things properly, you should be fine. But if you're still having an issue, then the only thing left to do is default the unit, default the cameras, and if still nothing, then update the camera firmware and the NVR firmware. All right, guys, so hopefully this fixes a couple of issues, especially with the second HDMI display, and that pretty much wraps it up. So thanks for watching, and please feel free to leave comments and anything like that, and hopefully catch you on another one. Cheers, thanks, bye bye.